Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some examples for the selection of a safety relief valve for an industrial refrigeration application. Coming up, selecting a safety relief valve for a single vessel, selecting safety relief valves for a common outlet, steps to remove the warning from safety relief valve selection, and generating a report. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Coolselector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already, links are in the video description below. In this example, we would like to first select a safety relief valve for a surge drum and then add another safety relief valve for the economizer with common outlet with the previous valve in an industrial ammonia system. We start the selection process for a safety relief valve by selecting the Valves and Line Components tab and then clicking the Safety Relief Valves option. You may notice that the selection page for safety relief valves is different compared to other selections. This is because selection of safety relief valves is not based on the load calculations, and all calculations for safety relief valves in Coolselector 2 are done according to the standard EN 13136 2013 plus A1 2018. We begin from the top left and choose whether the refrigerant will be released externally or internally. For this example, we'll choose external relief. Next, we choose which refrigerant we'll be using. We'll select R717 ammonia from the drop-down menu. Next, we need to consider the absolute back pressure. This is the pressure on the outlet of the valve. As we are selecting a safety valve for an external relief application, we will use atmospheric pressure of 1 bar. Now we need to define the location of the safety valve. We can choose between discharge from a vessel, a compressor, or alternatively, we can manually input the required mass flow rate if this is known. We'll select a vessel for the surge drum and rename this tab to surge drum. The screen will now refresh and ask you for your operating conditions and the vessel size information. We should start with the vessel size at the bottom of the page. We can define the shape and size of the vessel. We'll choose cylindrical vessel and then input a diameter of 2 meters and a length of 5 meters. Then we input the set point gauge pressure as 16 bar for the relief valve. This is just to suit our particular system. We have the option to input the inlet temperature. Otherwise, Coolselector 2 calculates the temperature using the absolute relieving pressure and the default value for the gas superheat. The absolute relieving pressure is calculated based on the standard using the absolute back pressure and a set point gauge pressure. In the case of a safety relief valve for discharge from a vessel, the default superheat is zero as vessels usually contain saturated refrigerant in two-phase conditions. If this value is different from the calculated value in our system, we should enable the inlet temperature and then input the correct value. We see that the application now warns that the valve selected is too small. We first need to choose a larger valve. If we select the valve SFV20 plus DSV2 25-25, we see the adjusted valve capacity is larger than the required capacity, so the valve size warning is removed. We should always try to select the smallest safety relief valve which can provide the required capacity for our system. In the results section, you can see the calculated absolute relieving pressure of the valve and the required capacity. Under this is the capacity of the valve selected and the adjusted capacity. The adjusted capacity is calculated based on the standard, and it is used for the calculation of pressure losses at the inlet and outlet of the valve. Then we have the inlet pressure loss and the outlet pressure loss, which are limited by the standard to guarantee the proper functioning of the valve. If we choose another valve, we see that it has an effect on both the inlet and the outlet pressure loss. We'll come back to this section later in the video. The standard also specifies limitations for pressure losses at the inlet and outlet of the safety relief valve, which is why the proper input for the piping at the inlet and outlet of the safety relief valve is important for the calculations. Let's first consider the outlet losses for the pipework. We can do that by clicking on the outlet checkbox in the schematic on the left. As we click this, some new inputs will appear on screen. We first define the pipework as being 10 meters in length, and we'll leave the default friction coefficient. For bends, we'll input 6 for this example, and we'll choose the type of bend as having a radius of 3 times the diameter. We can then input any custom elements, and for this example, we'll have one custom element with a pressure loss coefficient of 0.5. You'll notice that the application now shows a warning that the outlet pressure loss is too large and is greater than 10%. In some scenarios, we could select another valve to reduce this. but it is not possible in this case as we've already selected the smallest possible valve to satisfy the required capacity. Alternatively, we can adjust the pipe work by selecting a larger size. We can do that by unselecting the diameter same as valve option and manually defining this. We'll choose the larger size of DIN EN40 for this example, which will reduce the pressure loss and remove the error. At the bottom of the schematic, we can also enter our inlet losses by clicking on the inlet losses checkbox. We'll input an inlet pipe length of 1 meter and keep the default friction factor. We'll also leave the diameter as valve option selected. For bends, we'll input 0 and we'll also have 0 custom elements. Under this section, we can choose how the pipework is connected to the vessel as this impacts the frictional losses. We'll choose flush sharp edge from the drop-down menu. We can see that our selection result is okay for the specified operating conditions in our system and the calculated pressure losses. Now we need to repeat the procedure for the economizer vessel. We add a valve for discharge by clicking on the vessel option at the top. We will then rename this to economizer. This is a smaller cylindrical vessel, so we change the dimensions at the bottom first. We'll specify a diameter of 0.9 meters and the length of 2 meters. Now we'll input the set point gauge pressure of 22 bar. You will notice that the valve's required capacity is much smaller in this case. Now for the outlet losses, we add 10 meters of piping with 2 bends, and we'll choose the type of bend as having a radius of 3 times the diameter. You can see that there is a warning as the outlet losses exceed 10%. In this case, there is the possibility to choose a smaller valve. We can select the BSV8 plus DSV1 25-20. Notice that the warning is removed by selecting the new valve as it has a lower adjusted capacity compared to the previous option, which results in lower pressure losses at the outlet. At the inlet, we have 1 meter of piping with 2 bends, and we'll use the flush sharp edge connection type. In the results section, we can see that the result is still okay after adding the information for the inlet losses. However, we can see that there is now a panel on the left-hand side for the common outlet of the 2 selected valves, and there is a warning with our surge drum valve. When we have a common outlet for safety valves, it is important to include the common outlet piping in the calculation as well. In this example, our common outlet is 1 meter of pipe with 1 bend with a radius 3 times the diameter. To remove the warning for the surge drum safety relief valve, we should specify the diameter of the common outlet to be DIN EN40. Steps to remove the warnings from safety relief valve selection. In general, to select safety relief valves and remove the possible warnings, you can follow these steps. For each selection, select the smallest safety relief valve that is large enough to handle the capacity. Change the diameter for the common outlet pipe to a very large pipe size, if there is a common pipe. One by one, change the diameter of the individual outlet pipes until there are no errors for that selection. Change the diameter of the common outlet pipe until you reach the smallest diameter without warnings. Check whether individual outlet pressure losses are close to 10% for back pressure dependent valves or 20% for back pressure independent valves. If they are, evaluate whether it is possible to increase the individual outlet size and decrease the common outlet size without introducing errors. This last point is fine-tuning, and you should evaluate whether it is worth increasing individual pipe size so that the common pipe size can be decreased. We can generate a report for our selected product simply by clicking on the report button in the top menu bar. The window will then refresh to display our product report. In the left-hand panel, we have the option to add a project name, some comments, as well as an author name to the report using the inputs in the top left-hand panel. If you make a change here, then simply click the update button to apply these changes. Along the top of the report, we also have various options to export the report. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you enjoy this and it has helped you. If so, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions at all, let us know in the comment section down below. You can also find links to more Coolselector tutorials in the video description below. Do check those out. Once again, thanks for watching.